Good to see you again, man.
What's up, big fella?
What's up, brother?
Oh, you're right. Man, you got taller.
Yeah, thousands of people come through here, man. So it's a lot of food insecurities, you know. But at this moment, though, knowing that you're not going to be able to be here in September, when they put forth their act of kindness awards, you got to be in the bubble. Wanted to take this opportunity.
Want some award?
Yeah.
Oh, you didn't know?
No, I didn't know. You set me up, man.
Oh, man, no. You're getting the act of kindness award. You know, and in fact, the act of kindness, the humanitarian award, and you represent the first national figure that's getting this award. And normally it's done in September. Come on, introduce yourself. These are Cadetus Curry.
We just appreciate everything that you've done. And again, this is the first time that we had that. We just know not just what you do in the city, but what you do everywhere. And more importantly, you've always, your heart is about as big as you are, and you're a big old dude. And so it just means the world to us just to see somebody that's always trying to get back and make life better for everybody else.
But you got to tell me your story so you can grasp the significance of the award. Because this is a very personal award from these two. So just a little bit.
I lost two children, a 4-year-old, a 13-year-old, and my only brother, he was 25, to cancer. And so I know what a small act of kindness, you know, I empathize with so many people that struggle in silence. And every time I hear about acts of kindness you do throughout the country, it touches my heart that you see people that they don't have to tell you what they're going through. You just touch them by acts of kindness. And I just want to say thank you for the people that can't get to you, and I thank God for you being here. I almost want to cry, you know, just to say thank you.
They put on a big gala every single year. And I've been fortunate to be recognized by them.
When is it, the gala?
September 25th.
September 25th.
Yeah. I'll try to come back.
And so, but they wanted to go ahead on and present to you this act of kindness, humanitarian award. Just to say thank you, man, for everything you have done, doing, and will continue to do. So,
thank you, sir. It's amazing, man, how close our circles have kind of crossed. Who's that sexy man right there?
Thank you.
In fact, let me do this. Sure, you get ready.
Okay.
Just let my guy know the day to go ahead.
Okay.
I'll try to get those guys.
Oh, awesome.
Who's coming in for this great show? In Atlanta, I used to make cheesecake
out. I think that's the box.
Okay. Show. You saw this come through in the special room on Peachtree, bro. You saw this come through and take great care of you.
Oh, all right.
Shaq,
what
has been
to get this R from the Houston group Random Acts of Kindness?
I didn't know I was getting an award. One of my good friends, Officer Miles, he tricked me. He said we was coming out here to, you know, help some people out, hand out some food. But look, I don't deal with stuff like that. I watch the news all the time, and I try to put myself in other people's shoes. So an incident happened at a Walmart where a shooting and a little baby got killed. I didn't want the mom to have to worry about how she was going to pay for it. So I contacted Officer Miles. He took care of it. I've been doing that since 1992. In Orlando this summer, there was a football player that was getting ready to go. He's really good. was hanging out with some of the fellas. They got shot, and I contacted the mom and dad. Like, because I have children. I don't know what that feels like. I would never want to know what that feels like. So, look, I'm just trying to help people in need. If I knew I was getting an award, I probably wouldn't have came, but I don't do it for that. That's always the right thing to do. I'm proud of the mayor here. I've never seen a food bank this size, this enormity. It looks good. I'm actually going to take this idea and probably take this back to Atlanta and Orlando. This is well. I like how it's done. I like how it's organized. So I want to thank the mayor of Houston for inspiring me to do more in the communities that I live in.
What does it mean to be out here? And perhaps you're going to help hand some food out to those in need. That is near and dear to your heart, isn't it?
Well, I'm not here for that. This is the mayor's thing. I don't want to, you know, do the photo op of me handing food when I haven't been out here all day with all the other people. I was tricked to come here. I'm in town. My guy said, hey, just come by and say hi to the mayor. I'm good friends with Chief Hart, so I wanted to just come by and say hi. But I'm not going to hand out food if I'm not going to be out here all day with all the other people.
You have a most unique mask. Tell us about it.
Somebody gave me this the other day. Like, I would never make a mask with my name on it. But somebody said, here, we made you a mask. So I was like, thank you. Appreciate it.
Shaq, you can't be in Houston without me asking you, since you'll be at the bubble, how you look at the Rockets' chances this year?
I'm not going to be at the bubble.
How do you look at their chances?
I think the difference this year is everybody has the same chance. What I mean by that, they're playing in a ballroom. No home court advantage. It's you know, sort of like a big AAU tournament. They play, they walk the same way towards the same cafeteria, the same room. So I want to wish them well. It's kind of strange. It's kind of weird, you know, because me and you especially, when we used to, okay, they won the first two games. Now we're going to their place. Oh, they stole one. Can they close up? Like, you know, it's you know, we won't have that, you know, scenarios anymore. So now, no fans, no home court advantage. I really can't say who the thing is.
You don't.